Hello and welcome to this Cordic in Practice presentation. In this video, I will show you simple examples on how to use the cosine and sine math functions with the STM32 Cordic peripheral. In this presentation, I will give you some prerequisites required to go through this video in order to reproduce the example and demonstrate how to use the Cordic cosine and sine function in 0 over n mode as well as DMA mode. Before going into further details, it is recommended to have seen the first part of this video series called Cordic Overview. To reproduce the same example shown during this video, you will need to have installed STM32CubeMX, STM32CubeIDE, and STM32CubeMonitor. Finally, this video was done using a Nucleo G474RE. The Cordic cosine and sine functions take two arguments and generate two results. The first argument is the angle theta given in radians divided by pi, thus giving a range from minus 1 to plus 1. The second argument is a modulus defined in the range from 0 to plus 1. In case the cosine function is used, the first result will be the cosine theta value multiplied by modulus, and the second result will be the sine theta value multiplied by modulus. In case the sine function is used, the first result will be the sine theta value multiplied by modulus, and the second result will be the cosine theta value multiplied by modulus. Note that even if the scale parameter is not applicable for this function, it must be set to 0. The precision of the Cordic peripheral is defined by the number of iterations configured for generating the output results. In the case of the cosine-sine functions, the best precision that the Cordic could benefit from is when it is configured with 24 iterations or 6 cycles for 2 to the power of minus 19 maximum residual error. As a first example, we'll start with a cosine-sine function using the 0 over n mode. To generate a project, we'll be using STM32CubeMX. Once the Nucleo G474RE is selected as a target, in Pinout and Configuration tab, then in Category tab, expand the Computing category and select Cordic. Then check the Activated checkbox. Once STM32CubeMX is open, select Access to Board Selector. Select Nucleo 64, G4, Nucleo G474RE. Do not initialize out peripheral with their default mode, it's not necessary. Then you can just clear the pinout, go to Pinout and Configuration tab, Categories tab, go into Computing, Cordic, and click on the checkbox Activated. In order to make sure we are not losing the debug connection, go in System Core, System, Debug, and select Serial Wire. Now we can generate the project. For this, we go into Project Manager, and then we type a project name, for example, Cordic Cosine Sine. ZO for 0 over n. In project location, for example, in videos, Cordic. And we'll select the toolchain IDE, STM32CubeIDE. In code generator, we'll select add necessary library file as reference in the toolchain project. And we'll set all 3 pins as analog for power consumption optimization. And then we'll click on Generate Code. Then click on Open Project. STM32Cube IDE is opening and importing the project. And we will have our source code ready for building our example. This slide is showing an implementation of the COSF equivalent from the standard MAT library using the Cordic peripheral in zero overhead mode. X parameter is given in region and converted to fit the Cordic peripheral and range from -1 to +1 in Q131 format in input Q31. In this example, we choose to take benefit of the best precision provided by the Cordic for this function by taking 6 cycles to compute the result. We also set the scale parameter to 0 as mentioned earlier. The implementation for the sinf function is equivalent to the cosf function, but using the function called cordic function sin. Note that the cordic provides polling through HEL cordic calculate function and zero overhead through the HEL cordic calculate ZO function. We choose to use HEL cordic calculate ZO for performance reasons. To use this function, we will add float cordic cosine and cordic sin variable in user code 0, as well as a double radian variable in user code 1 section. Finally, in user code 3, we will implement a loop spinning around the 360 degrees of the circle and set the cordic Q31 cos F and cordic Q31 sin F in cordic cosine variable and cordic sine variable every 10 milliseconds. Note that every angle is converted from degree to radians. We are now back to our STM32Cube IDE project previously generated with STM32Cube MX called cordic cosine sin ZO, and we are going to look for the main.c file. So in core directory, src directory, we are going to open main.c and we are going to proceed as discussed earlier. So we are going to define the cordic cosine and the cordic sin float variables. Then in the user code begin section 1, we are going to define the radian variable in double format. And then we are going to define a loop that is going to spin around the 360 degrees angle using the cordic Q31 cosf and the cordic Q31 sinf function that we discussed on the previous slide. Then we will define the missing functions cordic Q31 cosf and cordic Q31 sinf that we discussed earlier also. So first we are going to define the function allowing to convert a float to a Q31 numbers, and the opposite, a Q31 number to a float. Then we are going to define the functions cordic Q31 cosf and the cordic Q31 sinf functions. Some of those functions need to have an additional include file. So for instance, we are going to add the include mat.h. We should now be able to compile our code. Here we go. We have our code ready to run on our Nucleo board. We will now set up a STM32Cube monitor project allowing to graphically visualize the output of cordic cosine and cordic sine variables continuously. We are going to use STM32Cube monitor in order to display the values of the cordic sine and cordic cosine during the lifetime of the code. First, we are going to add two buttons. one button to start the acquisition and one button to stop the acquisition. So the first one will be called start acquisition. A message sent will be start. And the second one will be stop acquisition. And the message sent will be stop. Then we are going to find a way to retrieve the variables value, cordic cosine and cordic sine, still the same. So we are going to define a group of variables. We are going to call it cordic values. And we are going to retrieve them from the binary file generated previously by STM32Cube IDE. So for this, we are going to look into, for example, the debug directory, in my case, of the project, select the cordic cosine sine 0 overhead ELF file. It's going to parse the ELF file and retrieve all the variables available from the binary. And we are going to select the cordic cosine and the cordic sine values. We are going to give a name to the group of variables, still cordic values. And then we are done. And then we are going to add a prob out. So we are going to call it my prob out. And we are going to select the prob from the connected Nucleo GeForce Event 4 array. So this one. Then we are going to link all the blocks for this part. Then our goal will be to retrieve the values and output them on the chart. So to do that, we first need to add a prob in to do the acquisition. So we are going to call it my prob in. And we are going to select the same prob that we selected for my prob out, which is the ST link connected to the GeForce Event 4 Nucleo board. Then we are going to add a processing block, which will allow to process the values previously acquired by STM32Cube Monitor. So this block is going to be linked indirectly to the variables block, which is called cordic values. It's going to see the cordic cosine and cordic sine that we previously selected in the variable block. And we are going to complete this step. Then we are going to use a chart, and this chart is going to be on the same place here. And we are going to call it trigonometric chart. And then we are going to link our different block one to one. We are going back to STM32Cube IDE and we are going to load the code into the Nucleo GeForce Event 4. OK. And you see the code is launching in the Nucleo board. So now the code is running, we can free run it. So it's going to run continuously, indefinitely, in order to display on the other side the cordic cosine and the cordic sine value. So in order to do that, STM32Cube Monitor is accessing also the debug port connected on the ST-Link. So we are going to disconnect STM32Cube IDE from the debugger. Now we are going back into STM32Cube monitor, and we are going to first deploy this solution and open the dashboard. And then we are going to start the acquisition. So what we are seeing is the Cordic cosine and the Cordic sine variable going from 1 to minus 1 continuously. Note that before launching the dashboard, you have to make sure that the probe are showing a green rectangle on both my probe out and my probe in. If it's showing in red, it's probably because in STM32Cube IDE, you did not disconnect the debugger from the board. We are now going to add a few more features to this diagram. First, we are going to add a clear button. So in order to do that, we are going to add a new button. Send a clear message in order to clear the chart. And we are going to call it clear graph. Then we are going to link the clear graph button to the trigonometric chart, because what we want is to clear the chart when we press the button. That's the first step. In the previous acquisition, the data were going from minus 1 to 1, and the amplitude was a bit small. In the case we want to increase the amplitude, we can add additional post-processing variables going to the processing block and add the 10x Cordic cosine and the 10x Cordic sine. Then we can add a switch that will filter those variables and only consider the increased amplitude values. So for instance, with the switch, we will need to add a name. So for instance, filter, because it's playing the role of a filter. Focus on the property called message.payload.variableName and look after the variable we just defined, the Cordic cosine and the 10x Cordic sine. Then we can validate. And then we can link the Cordic values to the filter and link the Cordic sine and cosine to the chart. Then we can deploy the solution. Once the solution is deployed, we can open the dashboard and look after the display. Start acquisition, and we will see the value now going from minus 10 to 10. So it's quite more visible. In the case you want to change the button position, you can go into the dashboard tab, into layout, then go into the home layer. Click on the layout button, and then you can position every button on the chart. So for instance, I consider there weren't close enough, or I can also decide to put the clear button just above the chart. So I validate it, I deploy again the solution, and then I launch the dashboard, and I can start the acquisition. Same result, but the position of the buttons are different. Can stop the acquisition. We are now going to demonstrate the quartic, cosine and sine function using DMA mode. Like for zero overhead mode, the quartic peripheral will need to be activated by checking the activated checkbox in pinout and configuration tab, then category tab. The additional configuration for DMA configuration will happen in the DMA setting tab. In DMA setting tab, click on the Add button and select Quartic Write. And then click on the Add button and select Quartic Read. We are now going to generate a new STM32Cube IDE project thanks to STM32CubeMX following the change we discussed. So first we click on Access to Board Selector. Then click on Nucleo 64, STM32 G4, and we select Nucleo G474RE, like before. We select No as far as initializing all peripherals with their default mode. We don't need it. And now we will clear the current pinout because we don't need it as well. So we click on Pinout. Clear pinout. So yes, we'd like to continue anyway. Then, like discussed earlier, we can go into computing, quartic. Then we click on the checkbox activated to activate the quartic peripheral. And then in DMA setting, we can go on the add button. We select quartic write. Then we go again on the Add button and we get to Quartic Read. Last thing, to keep the debugger connection, we go into System Core, System, Debug, and we select Serial Wire. When we can get to the Project Manager, we go and generate a project in Videos Quartic. And we call it Quartic Cosine Sine DMA. We want to generate it to run with STM32Cube IDE. We change few things. We'll do on code generator. We'll add necessary library file as reference in the toolchain project configuration file. And we'll set all three pins as analog. We can now generate the project. Once the project is successfully generated, we can open the project. The project is then successfully imported in STM32Cube IDE. This slide is showing an example of the cosine and sine functions in DMA mode. The parameter angle is representing a table storing a sequence of Q131 converted angles values, again values being in the range of minus 1 to plus 1. As before, we choose to take benefit of the best precision provided by the quartic for this function by taking 6 cycles to compute its result. We are also setting the scale parameter to 0, as mentioned earlier, and the number of reads to 2 to have for each Q131 angles, the cosine and sine results pair. This slide is showing the memory representation of the angles and the result for each angle given in Q131 format, here in radians but converted in Q131 format. We will get the pair cosine and sine result in the result table. We get one cosine and one sine for one angle. To use this function, we will add flock quartic cosine and quartic sine variable, as well as tables Q31 angles tab and Q31 theta tab in user code 0 section. Then, we will generate in Q31 angles tab the 361 angles value converted in Q131 format, and then call the previously defined function cordic Q31 cos sin array. Finally, in user code 3, we will implement a loop spinning around the 360 degrees of the circle and set the cordic cosine and cordic sine from the results stored in Q31 theta tab every 10 milliseconds. We are now going back to our previously generated STM32 cube IDE project called cordic cosine sine DMA. In core directory, src directory, open main.c file. Then in user code section 0, define Q31 angles tab and Q31 theta tab, as well as cordic cosine and cordic sine float variables. Then, in user code section 2, load the 361 angle in Q131 format in Q31 angles tab. And then call the previously defined cordic Q31 cos sin array. Then in user section 3, for each angle, load continuously the cosine and sine value in cordic cosine and cordic sine variables. We are now going to define the missing functions. F32 to Q31 and Q31 to F32, allowing to convert a float to a Q31 and a Q31 number to a float. Then we are going to define the previously discussed function cordic Q31 cos sin array. And then we are going to add the missing header file, which is the mat.h from the mat standard library. We should now be able to build our project. Now, we are able to load our project into our Nucleo board. And now we can run to execute our code. We are now going to reuse the same STM32 cube monitor project, allowing to graphically visualize the output of cordic cosine and cordic sine variables continuously. In order to use STM32 cube monitor, we will need to release the debugger by clicking on this button in order to disconnect STM32 cube IDE from the debugger. Then in STM32 cube monitor, we are going to go to the variable group, cordic values, and load from the new executable cordic cosine sine DMA the new ELF file. We still have our cosine and sine value. We can update the project, validate. Then we can deploy and launch the dashboard. Then we start the acquisition. We have the same behavior than the one we had with the zero overhead mode. Thank you for watching this quartic cosine sine example in zero overhead and DME mode.